Happy Pandemic Tuesday to you. Happy Pandemic Tuesday to you. Happy Pandemic Tuesday to you. Stay home. Stay safe. I love you. Anyway, hi guys, how are you? It's April from Mama Loves Food and DinnerHero.com. I hope you're well. I hope this Tuesday finds you well. I hope you're making tacos tonight, because tacos are delicious. I made tacos last night, in case you were curious. I might make them tonight, too. It's true. I might. I've not gotten my sleeping back in order yet. Hi, Miss Amanda. How are you? Hi, Miss... Excuse me. Hi, Bobby. I haven't gotten my sleeping back in order, which is evidenced by the fact that it's 10:59 a.m. in my area of the world, and I'm just now getting on. So, there's that for you. But I was at least a little bit productive last night. I wasn't just tossing and turning. I stayed up and worked. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. It's just a thing. Hi, Miss Karen. Chicken and dumplings sounds delicious. I do love chicken and dumplings. We haven't made that in a very long time. I should do that. We have chicken and dumplings in the Dinner Hero book, in case you were curious. It's very easy to make and very delicious. Good morning, Miss Tina. How are you? So, go ahead. Oh my goodness, what is wrong with my voice today? Go ahead and put your mental health number. Oops, sorry. Put your mental health number in the comments. I'm going to go with like a 6 today. Yesterday I was feeling real good, and then I had a surprise visitor. Aunt Flo stopped by. I know, you want to know all these things about me. It's kind of wreaked havoc on my good mood. I don't know what dinner is, but dessert will be key lime pie. Maybe dinner is key lime pie. Maybe switch things up a little bit. I hope you're well too, Miss Lori. Anyway, so yeah, put your mental health rating in the comments. 10 is fantastic. 1 is not so hot. Not so hot. And if you see someone that is below a 5, I'd love if you reached out to them and said, hello, how are you? Hello, is it me you're looking for? Just kidding. What's wrong with me? Sorry, I'm a little loopy today. Stayed up late last night. I'm working on, we're going to have a tater tot casserole recipe on the website today. And I was thinking, maybe we could make some cracked chicken live tomorrow. Or either tomorrow or Thursday. I don't know. Amanda's going to make the scalloped potatoes and peanut butter bread in the oven. Yum. Yum. Okay. So, today's recipe of the... What is going on with my voice, you guys? Not sick, I promise. Today's recipe of the day is... sour cream coffee cake. This is Aunt Becky's recipe. Well, sort of. Aunt Becky's recipe starts with cake mix, which you can totally use cake mix. And there's instructions in there how to do that as well, I think. If not, just bug me and I'll tell you. yes. And it's delicious. It's one of the most delicious things you'll ever make and put in your mouth. So I think everybody should go ahead and make sour cream coffee cake today or sometime this week. It's very, very delicious. It does not taste like sour cream. I had my son, when I made it the first time, was like, sour cream cake, mom. It does not have a sour cream flavor. It just makes it really moist and delicious and cinnamony. And it's just, I always make a double batch and then it freezes beautifully. So, that's our recipe of the day. Did I put it in the comments? I think I put it in the comments. So make that, please. And if you don't make it, just go ahead and click over and look at it, because it's beautiful to look at. Deliciously beautiful. And then maybe you'll decide to make it. I don't really have a lot to talk about today. I feel like I'm just going to kind of blow smoke and waste time. I hope you are okay with that. Good morning, Miss Sherry. yeah, I'm still struggling with my sleep. How are you guys doing? Are you sleeping okay? I feel like sleep has suffered a lot with this pandemic situation. My sleep always suffers, but maybe I'm just noticing it more. I don't know. And also, I'm going to be totally honest. I mean, I'm always totally honest, but I'm a little bit jealous of Wes today. Wes took the day off, and I shouldn't be, because he had a big project that was due. And so he's worked for 6 days for like 14-hour days, And he even worked on Easter, which stunk. Not all day on Easter, but most of Easter. And so he took the day off because he turned it in this morning. And he's been playing video games with the kids, and I'm very jealous. I just want to go inside and play video games with the kids and take the day off. But I really can't because I have stuff to do. But it's okay because I like my work, so it's okay. Amanda says, I'm much more restless in my sleep. Like, I wake myself up talking. Beth says, I'm about a 4 here today. Bad insomnia, and I woke up in a lot of pain. I'm sorry. That really stinks. Good morning, Miss Connie from Minnesota. How is it? How's the weather in Minnesota? It is hot in Florida. I think that's putting me cranky mood, too. I think everything's just putting me in a cranky mood today. I'm sorry. I'm not interesting today in the slightest. Good gravy, April. I'm just not. I think I just shared twice by accident. Oops. Sorry, whoever's page that was. Didn't sleep well. Took me forever to fall asleep. So I've always been like a pretty avid dreamer, and they're getting just. I'm dreaming about stuff I don't want to dream about. Does that make sense? Mom, get days off. No, not really. Although I do like to play video games. Do you guys play video games? Hi, Miss Kelly. My personal favorite. I think we've talked about this before, but we're going to talk about a lot of things more than once. Ah, blessed caffeine. If you haven't played the Lego games... on like PS4, I think they have them for all the game stations, but the Lego games on like PS4, and my son has it on the Wii, and I think they have it on the Xbox and all those other ones too. They're so fun. I love them, and they're like very clean fun. Hi, Miss Charity. I stink at video games, so no. Oh, I'm not very good at them, don't get me wrong, but the Lego games are fun, and they're clean games, and you can like break Legos and go on adventures, and we have a bunch of them. I got them at GameStop really cheap, and so, yeah, I'm right now working with the Harry Potter ones. I just finished 1 through 4, and now I'm going back because there's, like, all kinds of mini quests, and anyway, it's funny because I play usually, you know, on the weekends I'll play for, like, an hour, and my kids, whenever they would have friends over, obviously not now, but pre-pandemic, their friends would always make comments like, your mom plays video games? I didn't know moms played video games. Love video games. I don't get to play them a lot though. I do play them on my phone a little bit at night when I can't sleep. Merge Magic is my current obsession. I've been playing it for like a year now though, so I don't know if I can really call it current. Take it and leave it. Old school Mario games. Yes! So, random, but when we first introduced video games to our kids, which was like a million years ago now, they've been playing for a long time, but we decided, because we had our old Nintendo systems from when we were kids, and or college maybe, I don't know. I probably bought a secondhand one in college. Anyway, so we made the kids learn how to play the original Nintendo before we would let them play on the newer game systems. Sorry, that was gross. I just burped twice. So yeah, and my kids were like shocked when they realized I know all the secrets and can like blow through levels, and I love that. We should pull that out again. I wonder if it still works. Anyway, right now they play the PS4 mostly, but we also got, so over Christmas time, we always stay with my parents at Christmas, down in South Florida, and at Christmas time it rained like the whole week. So the kids were all stuck inside. So I ran out to GameStop and got, guys, I love GameStop, by the way. I ran out to GameStop and got one of those all-inclusive game consoles with all the old games like built into it. So I got the old Sega, and so they've been playing a lot of the really old school games on that recently. So we've got 5 kids, so we've got two game consoles set up, and I don't know whether to be proud or embarrassed of that fact, but yeah, and they're only like 30 or something bucks, I think. So if I'll have to find that on Amazon, that was a really good pandemic buy. I mean, we didn't buy it for the pandemic, we bought it at Christmas time to you know, keep the kids from going crazy because we were all stuck inside. I don't even, all in one, what would you call it, all in one, I think? I'll have to find it. Anyway, yeah, so that one's been really fun. Here it is. This classic game console. This is the one we got. Oh, maybe it was a little bit more. I don't know. Maybe it was $70. Anyway, it was worth every penny. I don't remember. I thought it was like 40, but also maybe they raised the price because pandemic pricing. I don't really know. Anyway, I would say it's worth $70 though, but I don't know. It's not letting me grab the link. I'll try and drop the link when it loads. That's a good one. And it's got all the games in it, which is really nice. So you don't have to like pay for the game separately. And it's got a lot of games. I think it's like 50 or more games. I don't know. Don't quote me on that. I don't know what I'm talking about. You guys. Okay, here. Sega all in one. And it's got the game controllers and stuff. Like, you literally just plug and play. And, it's fun. It's also funny because in my mind, like, remembering back, like, the graphics were decent, right? Like, oh yeah, there was the Sonic the Hedgehog and he got the shiny gold coins, and looking back and my kids playing it now, I'm like, oh my gosh, it was a pixelated hot mess. but yeah, anyway, it's fun. I like it. I don't know what else I was gonna say. Okay, so recipe of the day is the coffee cake. Definitely make it. If you don't make it, just click it and look at it, because please. What else did I put in this thing? Oh, the other thing, I thought of another thing that my kids are really, really enjoying. If you don't want your kids on video games all day, which who does? I mean, although it does occupy them. But good morning, Miss Patricia. Yeah, I have a hard time with the new games too. I find I think that's why I like the Lego one, because it's more basic, right? Like, it's not 47 different buttons you need to know, and it feels more like what we played growing up. Okay, so if you have kids and you want them to be occupied inside and for many, many hours, my kids are loving these things called Mighty Beans. And I put the link in the comments. Okay, I should have brought some out. I'll bring some out tomorrow. They're like little beans like this. They come in like a pill like looking thing, and you open it and there's a bunch of beans inside, and they all have like, the beans have little faces on them, and you remember like the Weeble Wobbles wobble but they don't fall down things? They're kind of like that, but they all have characters and like points, and they play games with them, and I don't even understand how it works, but hours of playing, like, for days and days and days on end. so I put a link to that. And that's a big box of, I think it's got a bunch of them in there, but, yeah, you can get all different ones. And there's, like, you know, special collectible ones and whatever. Anyway, so those have been fun, and all my kids play them, like, from the 6-year-old to the 13-year-old really like it, so that's a fun one if you've got, like, a big age gap. That's a good one. So I don't know what I was gonna say. So yeah, what are we talking about? You guys are quiet today. Is it because I came on later and everybody's busy and working? What's the other thing? Oh, should we check our stocks? Those of you who have been hanging out with me since the beginning know that we've been collecting stocks on Robinhood.com. I'm spending my coffee money every morning. Not every morning, that's not true. Like, once a week on buying stocks. We are, we're like half up, half down today. Anyway, I'm trying to buy like a $5 stock every once or twice a week. Kind of what I spent on McDonald's or coffee before the pandemic. And I figure the stock market is in the shitter right now. So, it's a good time to try and learn about the stock market, of which I know nothing, and, get a few stocks. And I feel like odds are good that I'm not gonna lose the money, the capital I put into it, and I might even make some money from it. So, unlike the McDonald's, which I would eat and put in my belly. So, anyway, I just put a link to the Robinhood if you want to sign up for it. You get a free stock and I get a free stock if you sign up using that link. Yes, you do have to put your social in. Yes, you do have to put your banking information in. It is a real banking app. Anyway, and the free stock is like a $3 or $4 stock, but it's fun. My husband and I are having a competition. He's winning today. Farrah says, your lips and nails are fire. Impress Nails. I'll put a link. They're my favorite thing in the whole world. They make me feel like a human. I don't know why I like nails so much. I just do. Anyway. I love nails. Am I near Fort Myers? I'm watching an eagle nest on live camera. No. I am northeast of Orlando. Yeah. They're stick-ons. And then this is the, the Maybelline lip crayon, which I also adore. I love Maybelline products. Do you guys like Maybelline? Last coffee. I'm sending help ASAP. Any other teen-specific good finds? Oh, I gotta think about that. What are my teens doing? My teen boys, well, I have 12 and a teen. I have a 12 and a 13-year-old. Joined, if you have a basketball hoop, there's a girl on Instagram. She's a former professional, or maybe just a, I don't know if she's former. I think former because everyone's former because there's no basketball right now. Anyway, she's a professional basketball player, and she put together, I'm just looking for her name on here, she put together a middle school league. There's a middle school boys league and a middle school girls league. And they have to do, like, drills during the day and, like, record themselves. And, my kids have really been into it. Let me see if I can find. That's a good one. Making them read a lot. They're reading through the Hunger Games and then we're watching it. So we watched Hunger Games. The first one on Friday. And, shoot, I'll have to look for it later. I don't know. I don't remember her name off the top of my head, but, yeah. So reading a book and then, like, with the idea of watching a movie at the end is good. They're playing a lot, like I said, they're playing a lot of basketball in the driveway. I mean, we are allowing a lot of video games, I'm not gonna lie, more than normal. Farrah says we bought a glow-in-the-dark ball for nighttime. Ooh, that's fun. I like that. That way they can hoop alone. Smart. Our community took our hoops down, which I think is also smart because, at least in our neighborhood, if your neighborhood's being responsible, then yay, that's fantastic. But our neighborhood was not being responsible, and lots of people were gathering at the hoop. So, yeah. What are the teens doing? I don't know. What do teens do? They're texting their friends a lot. We let them get the Facebook, kids messenger. So yeah. Have any of you done good online interactive games for teens? Oh yeah, my teens, we got them the PS Plus. So we have the PS4. So we subscribed for the PS Plus, which I think is like, is really hot outside, Denise. Yes, it is, not as hot as yesterday. It's like 83. But it's overcast in 83. Like, the sun is not out, and it's still 83. And it's muggy. It's so muggy. Yeah, the PS Plus has been great. So, I don't know the exact mechanics behind it, but you pay, like, I think it's, like, 10 or so bucks a month, and then they can play with their other friends who have it. But the really cool thing that they discovered and are super loving, well, two things. One, PS Plus gives you a free game every month, which is really cool. And kind of pays for itself. And then on top of that, if you have a game, if you own a game, but your friend doesn't, you can invite them to play it with you anyway. So you don't both have to have the same games, which has been really cool. They've been able to play a lot of games that they had never played before with their friends, which is really cool. Because their friend had it and they didn't, and they invite them to be the second player in the game. So Kelly says, I just discovered a website that lets you order science kit for reasonable prices. Oh, that's awesome. Owl pellets. Oh my gosh, we did owl pellets a while back. But my kids liked it. yeah, that's all I got right now. I'll try to brainstorm on that though. Anyway. All right, guys, I think I'm going to get to work. Yeah, visit the website, mamalovesfood.com. If you are running out of dinner ideas, let us help you with that. Dinnerhero.com. We've got not only your list for stocking the fridge, freezer, and pantry, we've got dozens and dozens of ways to cook your proteins, and then on top of that, an additional 70 plus, I think it's like 70 or 80 recipes, really, really simple, easy dinner recipes that to make with all those ingredients so that you can stock your pantry once and make all kinds of fun different things. Anyway, you guys have a great day. I'm sorry I was a little bit like today. It's just that kind of day. But y'all look gorgeous. How about family, like your family and my family, Yahtzee, or something family friendly? We've been playing a lot of Ticket to Ride. We like that one. Yeah, Lori, dinnerhero.com. But also just the website, mamalovesfood.com. We've got hundreds and hundreds of recipes there. I wish I would have bought the book before the pandemic. Amanda, get it by ebook if you don't want it. We've got an ebook version, which gets delivered instantly. Literally, the moment you click pay, the link is right there for you to download it. And then, yay, Sherry ordered last night. High five, girl. If you prefer a physical book, we have that option is available as well. There's also a bundle if you want both, so you get a discount on that. I'm sorry, I don't know what's happening right now. What's I gonna say? My kids love Monopoly. I personally hate Monopoly. I think it's like the worst game ever. I don't know. We haven't been playing a ton of board games. We've got those, the Funko games, but I haven't played a bunch. I played once with the kids. It was a lot of fun, but they're a little bit involved, so that's good for older teens. So the Funko games, if you have those are board games, so not online interactive. Yeah, we haven't really deep dived into the online interactive games, so maybe we'll do that. I did read that you could play Cards Against Humanity online. That could be fun. Not for teens, for adults. Okay, guys. You're gorgeous. I'm going to sign off. MamaLovesFood.com, DinnerHero.com. Have a fantastic day. Just have a good day. And if you don't, take a nap. I think I might do that today. Y'all are the best.